Alright, hi everybody. I decided to start narrating from this point instead of doing the typing before because I was getting tired of typing all that out, and it's a little bit quicker this way and I got a lot to talk about. So basically with this reference sheet, what I started out doing is I put three lines across. One across where the top of his head would be, in and around that area. One across the midline and one across with the feet. Simply because I'm drawing this character three times across his page in three different poses, and I wanted to make sure I got everything lined up well. Alright, after that I started on my first sketch. My first sketch, of course, is the one from the front view. That's the view that's going to show the most of your character. It's going to show his face and most of his clothes and a lot of different things. So, and that's also the one I colored because it shows the most. That way I get a better idea of the colors of his outfit, and I also get an idea of the color of his hair and his eyes better that way and stuff like that. So that would be your most important sketch. And then the two after that I did in black and white pencil line art because I'm doing it as a manga style comic, you know. So the line art is going to be the most important thing for me because that's what I'm going to be doing a lot in my series instead of color. Color will be on special pages. But the color will also help you getting a better idea of toning in a comic. If you want to do a lot of detail in toning, you need to get it set out in color first, because that's what your grays are going to be based off of. So once you look at it color, you can get a better idea of toning. Okay, and we're back. I had to do several videos with this because I'm videotaping this off blog TV, believe it or not. Anyways, now that I got my three sketches laid down, well, see, I already had a lot laid down before I turned this on for you guys to speed things up a little, but I got my first sketch done, and what I did with that was I sketched it out. It's what I did with these two, only with color. I sketched everything out, rough as you have to be at the beginning. It doesn't matter, just make sure you can clean it up later on. Lay down your character, and what I really recommend doing when doing a reference sheet is do your character in his natural pose, whatever he would most likely do. Like, I even tried several different things, several different attitudes, and this will help you get a good idea of how to draw your character, but at the same time, you'll get a better idea of the attitude of your character and how to really draw your character, how to draw your character so that he comes to life on the page, if you won't make it all philosophical with it. So what I did was I did that with the first one. My character is a generally happy dude, so he's smiling and just kind of got an arm up like he's waving or something, so yeah. In the next few poses, I tried a few different things. Like the second pose, I tried something where he looks a little bit more concerned and he's got his hand resting on the sword hilt there, almost like, you know, he's a little freaked out. And then the one from the back, I tried to make it look like he was a little bit more slouching, a little bit more attitude to the pose and stuff, to get something interesting going on. I got more bend in his knees, and his arms look kind of like they're swinging. So, I thought that would be cool to do. So, I would recommend doing something like that on your own. Just get creative with it. Make a drawing more fun for yourself. But go in as messy as you have to when you're first sketching out your character. Just try to get your anatomy right, and it will be messy starting out as an artist. I know mine is. Mine is extremely messy. That's why I did all my sketching and got some basic stuff laid out before I started this video. Then go in and clean up your sketches. Clean up your line art. Y'all see me doing that in this video right here a lot. I'm going in with my eraser, pink gummy, and then I use the one on the pencil, but I'm wearing it down. That's how much I erase. I go in and I erase what I don't want, and I put back in what I do want, and I just do that until the lines look clean and done. And so go in and sketch out your anatomy first, and then you can start into clothes and features and stuff like that, and that's going to be the fun part. That's going to be the part that will really set your character apart. But, like I said, also the pose can do that too. Okay, time to finally tie this thing up and go ahead and get it done. And this drawing kind of speaks for the whole tutorial. If you take a look at it there, it's everything I've said so far, and it's a pretty simple concept. Just set up your three drawings, get a drawing good from all sides. I recommend, you know, you can have one or two from the side. You can have, like, two different drawings from the sides because there's two sides to each person. You know, you can get one from the left and the right if you like, but I just did one because I was running out of paper space. But I got that. I got my color drawing and I got my line art. And when it comes to character costume and stuff like that, I can't really tell you what to do too much. Just try to study real clothing a lot is what I've tried to do, and study how the seams and clothes work, because seams will tie clothes together in a certain way. If you look at your shirts, there's a lot of seams are in the same places in your shirts, like at the top of your sleeves, but also they add some detail and interest and a cool look to the clothes. And so, you know, study some real stuff and get a better idea of that. And there's me showing off the finished work, I think. Yep. And now I'm going to work on the ESC page for you guys for a few seconds or minutes or whatever. Yeah, seconds. This is just me going in on the sketch phase of an ESC page. I thought it'd be fun to put this in at the end since I finished up the other with some spare time on the video. Go ahead and use up all my video time. But, yeah. This is what I do. It's really, really messy. I don't even start out with straight lines. I go in and do like a really quick slash line and then get the scenes in as fast as I can. Because it comes pouring out of my head pretty fast. And I want to get it. I want to get the feeling and emotion down. And so if you guys are doing a series like that, that's what I can really recommend, is kind of do it spur of the moment if you have to, and or even do like a quick sketch and then go off that sketch later on and figure out what you're going to do later on and make it neater. Because you, in a comic, you're trying to portray emotion to somebody else. You're trying to portray emotion and events and such. And so I have to do it super fast, and I have to do it as fast as it comes into my head. It comes in my head in a series of images, and I have to get it out. And so, that's my big comic lecture. Just make it creative and make it your own, really, in the end. You know, you'll have more fun with it if you do. Bye! 3 in. Alright, and finally, this is the finished project. I want to show you this to you guys to show you what it looked like after I did a little bit of editing on the computer. I used a free copy of Corel Painter Essentials 4 that came with my computer, and a tablet. I used the Intuos 4 Medium, I think is what it is. And basically, I cleaned it up some, and you can spice up your character reference. I went in and did the blue lines instead of just my plain pencil lines for the three lines across. And I added in some character reference stuff, some interesting little facts, tidbits, you know, fun junk. Make the reference a little bit more than just a reference, just something that's all business. Because I wanted to make it fun for other people to look at and read, not just me. Because I use this too when I'm drawing the character on the page. But I also want to use it as a finished work and use it as something that people enjoy looking at. And so that's something you can do for fun. You know, just make it your own if you got that kind of software and that kind of time. Bye!